Electability. It has been the buzzword for the 2020 Democratic primary, a sort of nirvana the candidates are trying to reach to convince voters they are the best to beat President Trump. So how is that electability factor steering voters' decisions when they head to the polls? CNN's Jeff Zeleny traveled to the all-important state of Iowa to find out.
I identify as a Democratic socialist. Progressive policies speak to me. That's what I prefer.
Maggie Willems is a proud liberal, but 2 months before the voting begins, she's in a moderate mood.
I also understand that I'm not representative of the whole electorate, and we need to be sure to select a candidate that can defeat Donald Trump.
Here in Mount Vernon and in towns across Iowa, Willems and other Democrats are thinking hard about electability as they search for the best candidate to defeat President Trump. For most of the year, the Democratic race has been driven by left-leaning proposals, from the Green New Deal to Medicare for All to free college.
When we give up on the big ideas, we give up on the people.
But in the final weeks of 2019, moderates are fighting back, like in this ad from Pete Buttigieg, where he takes a thinly veiled swipe at Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren's plans.
There are some voices saying, well, that doesn't count unless you go even further, unless it's free even for the kids of millionaires. But I only want to make promises that we can keep.
Worried about Trump winning re-election, a pragmatic awakening is underway for some voters like Willems, a teacher who once thought she might support Warren.
Politically, I agree with nearly everything that Warren has to say.
How are you?
When we first met Willems on Labor Day, she was weighing two options.
Biden would be my pragmatic choice, and Warren would be a bit of a leap of faith in my heart.
But now she's ruled out both, souring on Warren's embrace of Medicare for All and skeptical of Biden's appeal to younger voters. She's leaning toward Buttigieg.
He has the ability to maybe talk across the aisle that more overtly progressive candidates might not.
Let me tell you, if you can't bring the country together, we're in real, real, real trouble.
While Sanders and Warren are still electrifying the party's liberal base, Buttigieg, Joe Biden, and Amy Klobuchar are steering the conversation to the middle, saying it's critical to appeal to a broader swath of voters.
You want to put someone on top of our ticket that brings people with them and doesn't shut them out.
Not a joke.
The message is resonating with Katie Haverkamp, an independent voter who plans to take part in the Iowa caucuses for the first time because of her disdain for Trump.
What kind of Democrat are you looking for?
I'm looking for someone that is moderate, that is a strong leader, and has integrity.
Thank you. It's good to be back.
She and her mother came to see Biden when his bus tour passed through Iowa Falls. They hope to check out Buttigieg soon. Back in Mount Vernon, Willems' social studies classroom is decorated with posters from campaigns gone by. She said finding a candidate to motivate Democrats and win over Trump voters is her chief concern.
How often do you think about electability?
Often. And I try and think of that middle third and how they might be persuaded to vote for the Democratic ticket.
That was Jeff Zeleny reporting.